After a long discussion, we have completed linear and non-linear systems in the last lecture, and the next classification is invertible and non-invertible systems. In order to understand invertible and non-invertible systems, you must know what do we mean by one-to-one mapping and many-to-one mapping. So before defining invertible and non-invertible systems, I will explain what do we mean by one-to-one mapping and what do we mean by many-to-one mapping. So let's understand one-to-one mapping first. In case of one-to-one mapping, for each and every possible unique values of input, the output will be unique. In other words, we can say that the output will not be same for two or more distinct possible values of input. To make you understand this, I will take one example. In this example, this is the set of all the possible values of input. Input is xt, and let's say there are three elements in this set, 1, 2, and 3 are the values of elements, and now I will draw the set of all the possible values of output. The output is yt, and let's say the elements are a, b, and c. Now in case of one-to-one mapping, all the three values of input will produce three distinct values of output. Let's say when xt is equal to 1, the output yt is equal to b. When xt is equal to 2, the output yt is equal to a. And when xt is equal to 3, output yt is equal to c. So you can clearly see all the three values of input are producing three distinct values of output. So this particular mapping is known as one-to-one mapping. And now we will understand what do we mean by many-to-one mapping. In case of many-to-one mapping, two or more distinct possible values of input will produce the same output. Let's understand this by the help of one example. In this example, this is the set of possible values of input xt. Let's say the values are 2, 4, and 6. And now I will draw the set of possible values of output yt. Let's say the outputs are a and b. Now this 2 here will produce the output yt equal to b. This 4 here will produce the output equal to a, and this 6 here will produce the output equal to b. So you can clearly see when xt is equal to 2, the output is equal to b. When xt is equal to 6, the output is again equal to b. So for two distinct possible values of input, the output is same, that is b. So this particular case is known as many-to-one mapping. There are many inputs producing the same output. And this is the mapping between input and output. Here also we have the mapping between input and output. So we are done with one-to-one mapping and many-to-one mapping. And now we can understand the definition of invertible systems. You can see the definition on your screen. For an invertible system, there should be one-to-one mapping between input and output at each and every instant of time. So in case of invertible systems, there should be one-to-one mapping between input and output at each and every instant of time. On the other hand, in case of non-invertible systems, instead of one-to-one mapping, we have many-to-one mapping. Let's take two examples to understand this. In example number one, we have the system relationship like this, yt equal to xt square. And we will check whether they follow the one-to-one mapping or many-to-one mapping. For this, I will make a table. And in this table, the first column is for the input and the second column is for the output. And I will choose different values of xt and we will calculate the corresponding yt. Let's say xt is equal to minus 2. When you put minus 2 here, you will have minus 2 square. Therefore, yt will be 4. Now let's put xt equal to 2. When you put 2 here, again you will have yt equal to 4. So we have many to one mapping. This minus 2 is producing 4 and this plus 2 is also producing 4. So it is case of many to one mapping, and as there is many to one mapping, the system is non-invertible. So this is our answer. Now let's take example number 2. In the second example, output yt is equal to xt plus 2. Again we will follow the same steps. First we will make the column for the input, then we will make the column for the output, and we will choose some values of input and we will calculate the corresponding output. Let's say xt is equal to 0. This will give us yt equal to 2. Let's make xt equal to 1. Yt will be 3. Xt equal to minus 1. Yt will be 1. So for different possible values of input, we have different values of output. So it is the case of 1 to 1 mapping. 0 is giving us 2. 1 is giving us 3, minus 1 is giving us 1, and in the same way, if you check the other values of input, you will get distinct values of output. So this case is the case of 1 to 1 mapping, and therefore we can say that the system is invertible. So I hope you now understand what do we mean by invertible and non-invertible systems, and what is one-to-one mapping and many-to-one mapping. Now we will move to the next part of this lecture, in which we will discuss one important property of invertible systems. The first box here represents the invertible system, and the second box here represents the inverse system of this invertible system, and they are cascaded together. So we have a composite system which we have obtained by cascading invertible system with its inverse system. When an invertible system is cascaded with its inverse system, then the overall gain of composite system will be equal to unity. Let's say xt is the input to the invertible system and the system is producing the output yt. And when this output yt is subjected to the inverse system of this particular invertible system, the output we will get is equal to xt. And when you calculate the gain, it will be equal to unity because output is same as the input. So the composite system is having the gain. Let's say the gain is hs for composite system. It will be equal to 1. Let's say the gain of invertible system is h subscript I s, and the gain of inverse system is h 2 s, then we already know from the control systems h s will be equal to h I s multiplied with h 2 s, and from here we can find out the value of h 2 s. H 2 s, the gain of inverse system, will be equal to 1 over h I s. So this is one important property of invertible systems. Whenever you cascade them with their inverse system, the composite system will have gain equal to 1, and the gain of inverse system will be equal to 1 by the gain of invertible system. I will explain you what do we mean by gain and what is this representation hs in the coming lectures. So this is all for this lecture. If you have any doubt, you may ask in the comment section. I will end this lecture here. See you in the next one.